Okay, Joe. Guy Junker here in Pittsburgh. I appreciate the time. As a former manager and player, I'm sure you can empathize with Clint Hurdle and the Pirates situation last night, and as an MLB employee, I mean, you back your umpires too. How did you view the play in particular?
Well, you know, it looked like Jerry Meals was in, you know, pretty good position to make the call. And obviously what he saw initially was different than I think you and I saw. And I think after reviewing it, I think Jerry, you know, realized he could have made a different call.
Are you, this brings the discussion up every time, you yourself, Joe, are you in favor of not complete replay in baseball, but expanded replay usage in baseball?
Well, we're talking about expanded, but, you know, as far as including the play that happened early this morning, it may have been last night, you know, I'm certainly not in favor of that. But in saying that, you know, it doesn't mean that if people have things to say about that, that I'm not going to sit and listen. But, you know, after being in uniform as a player and a manager and, you know, getting the advantage of, you know, coming out on the good side of a call like last night and coming out on the bad side of a call like last night, I realized that fair or unfair, it's what the game is all about. And I'm not going to say I'm stuck in the mud from the old days. It's just that it's an imperfect game, and it's one of those things. I talked to Clint earlier today, and, you know, he certainly was upset last night, and, you know, he was wishing he won the game, but, you know, this, you know, the umpire's a human too, and unfortunately it didn't work. This guy's a good umpire. You know, he comes to work every day and, you know, really cares a great deal, and unfortunately this happened. But again, it's something that baseball's been all about.
Have you talked to Jerry at all?
I talked to Jerry a couple of times, sure. And, you know, nobody feels worse than this guy because he takes a great deal of pride in what he does. And he'll, you know, he'd be the first to tell you that he feels worse than anybody else at this point in time, because when you're out there, especially out there in his long and understanding, once you get into that 9th, 10th, 11th inning, you know that every single play means so much. He certainly was aware of that, and, you know, that probably compounded the issue as far as how badly he felt.
One last question, Joe. The Pirates filed a formal protest, I guess, with the commissioner's office today, and or complaint, and, you know, a couple people have asked me about that today. I said, look, as far as I know, unless the umpire made a mistake in the rule, there's no reversing anything like this. It's a judgment call in the field, and it stands, correct?
Yes. Yeah, I think it was more of a complaint than a protest. So, you know, I think they wanted to call our attention to it, but, you know, certainly when it was taking place at 71 years old, I was in bed. So, but I, you know, first thing this morning, I certainly, you know, became aware of it, and, yeah, I've done a number of shows, and I'm glad I was able to, you know, to do the local show in Pittsburgh, which is very important. But as I mentioned, I talked to Clint, and, you know, he certainly isn't happy with it, but he certainly understands the game of baseball, and, you know, that's something we're going to have to live with, because I just think there's no other way to go.
All right, well, have a good trip to Cincy, Joe. I appreciate it. It's amazing what the TV ratings were here, even at 2 o'clock in the morning. They were through the, you know.
That's great.
Yeah.
I think it's a wonderful story, that whole Pittsburgh experience. I mean, Pittsburgh has been one of my favorite towns because I have friends there, and I, you know, been going there, obviously, for years, and it's just great to see this reemergence of, you know, that city.
Good journeys, Joe. Thanks for the time.
All right, guys, thank you.